Hello YouTube, it's me, Ken Tanaka, and right now, I'm about to do my one-man show, live, right here, at the Royal Tea in Los Angeles. Hi everybody! Hi. Thank you all so much for coming out. I'm really excited to see so many people. One, two, three. There's at least three people, and probably many more. So, hi, what's your name?
My name is Ryan.
Ryan, how are you doing today, Ryan?
I'm very well.
I'm also very well. See, this is how you put on a play. It's easy, and we're all going to do it tonight. Yeah. Ready? Come on! 1, 2, 3, 4! Ken Tanaka, one-man show. Come on! Ken Tanaka, one-man show. Today is a very exciting day for me because today is the day when I'm finally going to meet Jonathan and Linda Smith. And they'll be sitting right here. Actually, these seats are reserved, so if you see somebody coming in, I think Jonathan Smith will be here in a few minutes, but if you see somebody who looks like they are not Jonathan and Linda Smith and they start to sit down, please tell them that these seats are reserved. But if they look like they are Jonathan and Linda Smith, you can just stand up and say, "Stop! Ken, stop the show!" And I will stop and sort everything out. But some of you probably don't know what I'm talking about. So let me tell you a little bit about who I am. So my name is Ken Tanaka, and I come from Japan. You are probably thinking, "What? Shut up! You are crazy! You are not Japanese! You are a white person!" And it's true, I am a white person. I was born in Los Angeles, but when I was a very small white baby, I was adopted and I was taken to Shimane, where I was raised. So in the 1970s, Japan had a big boom economy, and it was very popular for Japanese families to adopt white babies and take them back to Japan. I was like Madonna and Angelina and Brad Pitt. They adopt babies from Africa and Asia and raise them. So, of course, people often ask me, "Ken-chan, what was it like growing up in rural Japan?" Well, it was kind of like this. I was a student at Daitocho Daiichi Shobako Elementary School. I was always getting in trouble for talking. Other than that, I was pretty much just your typical average Japanese student. My family ran a small dairy farm in Shimane. And when I was in junior high, I got the job delivering my family's milk on my bicycle. It was a great job. Everybody knew me. Ohayou gozaimasu! Ohayou gozaimasu! Old ladies invited me in for tea. Tsumetai mugicha ikaga deshouka? And yes, little children wanted to play with me. Ken-chan, asobou yo! Dame da yo, taraku ima shigoto shitaru ken. It was a great job, and I kept on delivering milk all through junior high, all through high school, all the way till I turned 33 years old. Then, one day, as I was bringing my bicycle up the driveway, my father came out and said he needed to have a very important conversation. I'm going to do this part in English, but it happened in Japanese. "Ken-chan, that's me doing my dad." "Yes, father, that's just me." "Your mother and I have always loved you as our own son, but Ken-chan, you are not born Tanaka Ken. Your real name is Ken Smith. And your biological parents are Jonathan and Linda Smith in the United States of America. In Japanese, there is the word shok, which means shock. That is exactly how I felt at that moment. Until my father said those words, I guess I never really thought too much about it. But I think somewhere, deep down in my heart, I always knew that there was something a little bit different about me. In Japanese, there is the concept of akai ito, or a red thread, and they say the akai ito connects from your heart to the hearts of other people who you love and care about. I guess I always felt like I had a few akai itos that were left dangling in the wind. And when I heard my father say those words, it made me wonder, what do they connect to? But what should I do? Stay, Ken, stay! Go, Ken, go! The voices of doubt were all around me.
American people have all guns.
But in my heart, I knew that my destiny lay far across the ocean, and I had to find out what was on the other end of my akai ito. It was my first time ever leaving Shimane, so everybody came to see me out.
Kenta! Ikanai de!
Chanta kaite kuru da yo!
Yes, Mama. Yes, Papa. Don't worry. I'll be back soon. Don't worry, I promise to brush my teeth every day! And so, I was off.
Well, this is your captain speaking. We're now cruising at an altitude of 36,000 feet.
America, I've seen all of your movies and your TV shows, where everyone looks so happy, and soon that will be me, when I find my new family in America.
But what if they're in Mexico?
Then I'll go to Mexico!
But what if they're incarcerated?
You'll never find them.
Flight attendants, prepare for arrival.
I'll find them soon. Because I have the address of the adoption agency. Taxi! 3541, 3543. Oh, 3545. I heard all about America's giant big box superstores. They really do have everything. Ooh, so many different flavors of cornflakes. Excuse me, what aisle is your adoption agency? As the sound of the skidding tires indicate, my search had come to a screeching halt. It turns out that the adoption agency had closed a long time ago and was replaced by a Target store. I guess a lot can change in America in just 33 years. I didn't know what to do, so I walked back to my motel room. I crawled into bed, and I cried and cried and cried until there was no more salt left to fill by Ken Tanaka teardrops. I tried to sleep, but I could not. At 3:21 in the morning, I turned on the little light next to my bedside table, and I opened up the drawer. Inside, I found a book. The Holy Bible. And underneath it, an even bigger book. The Los Angeles White Pages. I opened it up, and there I found Smith after Smith after Smith. A. Smith, Albert Smith, B. Smith, Bob Smith, J. Smith, Jonathan Smith, Linda Smith. There are 12 pages of Smith in the Los Angeles Paper. I called every single one.